Animals have achieved flight only a few times, but gliding they've done a lot more commonly. And even just today, there's the draco lizards, gliding snakes, gliding geckos, and the genus Halaspis, which also glides. So it's something that's widespread in just modern reptiles. However, their fossil record of gliding goes back even further into the Permian. The Wiggletosaurids were some of the earliest diverging reptiles, and the main genus known from the group, Wiggletosaurus, was found in the Permian of Germany and was studied in greater detail this month. The study mostly looked at the bones and essentially the proportions of the bones, and essentially they were able to lay out what a diagram of this animal would have looked like, where you can see some of the ribs do stretch out pretty far and would have been very likely to support a gliding membrane for this animal. And this is the first time we find evidence of gliding in land vertebrates in the fossil record. However, the study also did a phylogeny and was able to see what some of the closest groups the Wiggletosaurids were related to actually were. And most notably, they actually find it as a sister group to the Drapanosaurus, which were also doing a lot of weird things. For example, Drapanosaurus had very strange arm anatomy and was probably climbing in trees and digging through bark, whereas things like Skybolonyx were actually digging. So some of these early diverging reptiles were actually doing very strange things, be it gliding, climbing, or burrowing, and especially with this strange anatomy. So that does help to show that even though we don't have these groups today, understanding what they were doing in the past can help us understand the broader picture of what was happening through evolutionary time.